click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the 13th chapter of microwave engineering, where the different kinds of performance parameters are measured. So the title of the chapter is microwave measurements here. So in this chapter we started to see how exactly the low frequency measurement can be made possible. Next to that, we have been introduced to the very popular microwave test bench component with which we can have the measurements associated to the power and the voltage levels. In general, we can say the energy levels, that it is the slotted line with the help of the tunable detector there. Recently, we have completed the VSWR measurement technique with the help of the double minima method and other things also. So I hope it is very clear to know what exactly the VSWR stand for and the significance of the same. In the last video, we have solved one problem to have the calculation for VSWR. So let us have one more problem to practice VSWR measurement. So here we are provided with the problem statement. The problem statement is, you have two directional couplers in the bracket 20 decibels in a guide to sample the incident and reflected powers. The outputs of the two couplers are 3 milliwatts and 0.1 milliwatts respectively. What is the value of VSWR in the main waveguide? What is the value of reflected power? So this is the problem statement. To see this problem statement, we first of all find out what is asked in the problem statement. So as per the problem statement, we are required to have the value of VSWR inside the main waveguide. So as we have been discussing in this problem statement regarding the directional coupler inside the guide, basically the structure of directional coupler is that it has primary waveguide and secondary waveguide, but we require VSWR into the main waveguide here. Along with the VSWR, we require the value of reflected power. So as the two values, VSWR and reflected power, are asked here, I hope it will be helpful to work with the formulation in terms of reflection coefficient for the VSWR measurement. So VSWR and the reflection coefficient are dependent on each other, we can say. So that formulations we shall certainly look after to get this problem solved here. Now what is the given data? We have the two directional couplers in the bracket, the value 20 decibels is given. Basically, the directional coupler is either provided with the coupling factor or the directivity value. Let us see what it is and whether it is useful to us or not. Now, the two directional couplers and the purposes are also two here. So this is to sample the incident power and the reflected power. So out of the two directional couplers, one directional coupler for sampling of the incident power, another directional coupler for reflected power. So directional couplers are used for the purpose of taking some portion of the microwave power for analysis purpose. So one is for the incident and another is for the reflected case here. The outputs of these two couplers, one for incident, it is having the output of 3 milliwatts. For the reflected power, what directional coupler is, it is having the output of 0.1 milliwatt. So now we require the value of VSWR and the reflected power here. So as we require the VSWR and the further reflected power, I hope the helpful formulation to have this calculation is VSWR is equal to 1 plus gamma divided by 1 minus gamma, where gamma is the reflection coefficient. Let this can be equal to equation number 1 here. Now we want the value of gamma to be substituted here to calculate the VSWR. Now as we are provided the values of the powers, now the incident and the reflected powers can be denoted by P suffix I, P suffix R here. So the reflection coefficient gamma can be equal to square root of PR divided by PI. This formulation, equation number 2, can be used here. Now from the given statements, we have to identify the values of PI and PR. So as for the incident power case, we have the output of 3 milliwatts, and for the reflected we have 0.1 milliwatt. We can write PI suffix 100 is equal to 3 milliwatts, whereas PR suffix 100 is equal to 0.1 milliwatts here. So this will imply the value of PI is equal to 3 into 100, it will get to 300 milliwatts here. In the terms of SI units, it will be equal to 300 into 10 to the power minus 3 watts here. And this formulation implies PR, the reflected power, 0.1 into 100, that it is 10. So 10 milliwatts, or we can get it to the form 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 watts here. So now we have the input power and the reflected power, hence we can make substitution into the equation number 2. So from equation number 2, we write gamma is equal to square root of PR divided by PI. So if both the powers are in the ratio, so can be substituted into only one type of the unit, into the milliwatts or into the watts here. So I put here, this is 10 milliwatts PR divided by 300 milliwatts to the value of PI. So this ratio, and taking the square roots, simplifies to the value of square root 0.033 here. And finally, the reflection coefficient gamma can be obtained to the value 0.1816 here. So this is the intermediate value that we can use to have calculation of VSWR. Now from equation number 1, we can write VSWR is equal to 1 plus gamma divided by 1 minus gamma here, which is equal to 1 plus 0.1816 divided by 1 minus 0.1816. So this value comes out to be 1.44. So this is the VSWR for the required problem statement. So this was our problem statement, and as per the problem statement, we required the value of VSWR that just now we have determined, and also we were asked to compute the value of reflected power. So to make the use of reflection coefficient, we have calculated the incident and reflected power. So both the values have been determined for the given case here. By the next lecture, we shall be having the third problem to be practiced for the VSWR measurement. I hope you shall be continuing with us by subscribing Ekeeda channel for more such information onto the microwave engineering subject. Thank you.